A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 12th October, Saturday. On the front page, you have Camaraderi marks start of Modi Xi meet. So the second informal summit between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and China's President Xi Jinping began at Mamallapuram, which is a town famously associated with the Pallava rulers. And the two leaders spent a few hours here in the evening together, getting a glimpse of the blend of South Indian art and culture. You can see the details of the monuments here is also given about Arjuna's penance, which is located here, which we have discussed already in the detailed video for current affairs on 10th October. Then Panchrats, the shore temple. So all this is there. The Varaha caves are also located behind Arjuna's penance. So you should know about this. You can see another monument, Krishna's butter rail, which is a natural rock formation perched precariously on the hillock slope. So all these cultural aspects of Mamallapuram are to be known. The temple complex, which is a World Heritage Site. Then below you have industrial output shrinks by 1.1% in August. So this is IIP, Index for Industrial Production. It has contracted 1.1% from year earlier, following a growth of 4.3% in July. Means there's no expansion in the economy. It was growing at 4.3% last month for July 2019 data. And now for August 2019, IIP is in the negative. It has contracted 1.1%. So if you look at the graph here too, you can see the economy, how it has been doing. So it has gone down in August 2019. It's a sharp fall. So that is shown. Biggest fall was in November 2012, the global financial crisis. So this is there. Then next is Ethiopia PM Abiy Ahmed wins Nobel Peace Prize. So this is Nobel Peace Prize announced. Former Ethiopian Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed has won it for his efforts to resolve the long-running conflict with neighboring country Eritrea. So he achieved peace and international cooperation was shown by him, in particular for his decisive initiative to resolve the border conflict with the neighboring country. So it is seen, and this award is seen as a boost to Africa's youngest leader as he faces inter-community violence ahead of parliamentary elections in May 2020. So you can see this is second year in a row that an African has received the Nobel Peace Prize. It was Congolese gynecologist Denis Mukwege who shared the prize with Yazidi activist Nadia Murad in 2018. For their work combating sexual violence. Then below you have Metro Light coming soon to Delhi. So this has been considered Metro Light. That is Delhi Metro considering it a cheaper, smaller and slower urban rail transit system compared to the Metro Rail. So it will be a 10-20 kilometer line as such, which is being considered. And this is CBI declines to invoke murder charges against Kuldeep Sengar. So this is Kuldeep Singh Sengar, BJP MLA, expelled BJP MLA. He and his associates and the driver of the truck that collided with the car have been arrested. The charge sheet has been filed against them. And the police, the CBI as such, has not invoked murder charges against him. So this accident which took place with the truck resulted in the Unnao rape survivor in UP's Raibareli, who was traveling in the car with her aunts. The two aunts actually got killed in the incident and she was seriously injured. So in this case, where Kuldeep Singh Sengar, who is the accused, of rape by on the woman, on the Unnao rape survivor, it went in 2017 when she was a minor. So he's accused in that, and now this accident took place in which he is involved, and the CBI says no murder charge would be invoked against him. On page 9 you have RTI violations go unpunished, says study. So Tamil Nadu, Sikkim, Mizoram and Tripura panels have not imposed any penalties for denying information. So RTI Act marks 14th anniversary now, and report card analysis of its performance shows that government officials face hardly any punishment for violating the law by denying applicants the legitimate information sought by them. So, you know, it failed to impose penalties in about 97% of the cases where violations took place in 2018-19. So, RTI implementation has also been completely diluted, while we have already seen that RTI Act has been diluted. And there's rising pendency of cases too that we have seen because of non-appointments. So the laxity in imposing penalties allows PIOs to take liberties with the RTI Act at the cost of the public. And it leads to many unanswered applications and an equal number of delayed or illegitimately refused ones, resulting in large number of appeals and complaints to commission and the consequent long wait before appeals come for consideration. This is a disheartening manner in which RTI Act has been implemented. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is warm up to the valley. So this is regarding Kashmir Valley. It says center must lift its lockdown and release political prisoners to restore normalcy in Jammu and Kashmir. So block development council elections have been announced, and if leaders, political leaders are put under house arrest, the entire exercise is a sham. And this is ending malaise. So that is, it says what India needs is a closure to malicious prosecution based on manufactured outrage. So this is regarding the case of sedition filed against 49 eminent personalities in Muzaffarpur in Bihar. So such aspects are being discussed here, that India needs a closure to malicious prosecution. Then the lead article is regarding India-China relations, making a friend of a neighbor. So it says challenge before India is to deepen the tactical engagement with China, keeping strategic glitches at bay. So we have concerns with respect to China. We have a trade deficit, a huge trade deficit. Then even in our neighborhood, we have concerns with respect to China. But still, it's, the article says that there should be tactical engagement with it. The border dispute is also a rising dispute with China. And this is towards an Asian century. So this says as West reevaluates ties with China and India, there's an opportunity for a grand bargain at Mamallapuram. So this is again on relations between India and China. So China is already at war with USA, a trade war going on. So India-China relations have chances to improve. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have ground zero coverage on a particular issue. So this is actually regarding a murder in Kozhikode, in which 6 family members were killed, including a 2-year-old. So the accused says that he was planning this murder for more than a decade. On page 12, you have Tharoor not to join external affairs panel. So Mr. Shashi Tharoor, senior Congress leader, has declined to be a member of Parliamentary Standing Committee on External Affairs, citing his engagement as chairman of Standing Committee on Information and Technology. So he has headed the external affairs panel in the last Lok Sabha, and this time BJP has decided to keep the chair of the panel for itself. So this is the case. On page 13, you have complete coverage on Modi's meet, here you can see. And also, this is the Arjuna's penance. Right? You can see it's all detailed out here. And here you have about Veshti. So this was traditional Tamil attire of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, which he wore when he met President Xi Jinping. And this is regarding how Chinese Premier Xi Jinping preferred Hongqi to a helicopter. So Chinese leaders avoid traveling by choppers as a policy. And the discussions which took place on investment, unbalanced trade. On international page, you have Iran oil vessel attacked off Saudi coast. So 2 of Iran's tanks were damaged by suspected missile strikes, and Iran says it's investigating the incident. And below here you have regarding again US-China trade relations. So further development would also take place. Interim US-China deal is likely. Trump is expected to meet China's trade envoy. And this is Turkey pounds Syrian towns, sparking exodus. So Turkey and allied forces have been fighting now the Kurdish, and there's stiff resistance being shown here, and they're trying to seize Syrian border towns. And this is the third day of the offensive, and it has sparked a civilian exodus. So people are moving out of the region. And President Donald Trump, whose order to pull back US troops from the border effectively triggered this invasion as such, is also a fact. It is said to be third such Turkish operation since the start of the war in Syria. And there is, fierce international condemnation of this act, including the act of Donald Trump. On business page, you have India rejects RCEP e-commerce chapter. So, as we had seen in news earlier, that if this e-commerce chapter of RCEP is accepted by India, then RBI's data diktat, data localization norms, cannot be implemented. So, acceptance of this would have prevented India from implementing rules on data localization. So, India has rejected this e-commerce chapter of RCEP. So, we'll have to wait what happens further. And this is for the first time in financial year 2020, credit grows in single digit. So, banks' deposits growth is also slow, and credit growth is also in single digit. You can see bank credit growth slowed to a single digit at 8.79%. Then there is no news on the last page. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashara.com. Thank you.